Hey guys, it's your girl Marielle. Welcome back to my channel, Friday Night Light Reviews, where we do reactions and reviews to television shows, movies, and other digital content. So before we get into anything, you guys go ahead, please like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. Please share the video with your friends and family. Let's get to 400 subscribers. I know we can do it. Also follow me on my other social media platforms, Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, where you see other content that we put up there. As always, if you are a new subscriber, welcome and thank you for joining our family. And if you are just new to the channel, just new to the video, since you're here, you might as well go ahead and click that subscribe button. Please, guys, don't forget to leave me comments on any TV shows or movies that you wish for me to review or react or anything that you have seen. So let's jump right into it. Today we're going to be reacting and reviewing Amazon's original limited series called Solos. The series was created and directed by David Well. I hope I'm saying his name correct. And it is a 7-part anthology sci-fi series that tells a story and explores what it means to be human, arguing that we are all connected to others through shared experiences, even in our most isolated moments. So, you already know what we're gonna do. We're gonna talk about it, put in our pros and cons in it, and then overall just say what we thought about it and then give it our stars rating. So, like I said, it's seven-part series, and the first character is Leah, played by Anne Hathaway. So, won't give you any spoilers for you, so you guys can watch it for yourself. So, Leah is a scientist currently talking to her present, past, and future self, trying to figure out how she can do it, and she is successful, and she does have a meaning behind it, and why she's doing what she's doing. I love Anne Hathaway. Without even like a side note, everybody that's in this series either have won an Oscar or have been nominated for an Oscar or a myriad of awards, or have acted or directed or whatever in a nominated film. So with that being said, now with Anne Hathaway, and she's great, but is her acting great in this first episode? I'm gonna say it's not her best. I think her storyline is what carries her through this episode. And the episode meaning and purpose behind it, it is very interesting, to say the least, but it's not her greatest, but the concept was great. The next person we have is Tom, and Tom is played by Anthony Mackie. Now, in his episode, he is a man who found out that he has terminal cancer and he's dying, and he spent $30,000 to purchase a robot me to take care of his children and his wife when he passes on. Now, the one thing I will say about this series, each and every character minus Morgan Freeman, they have been acting just one-on-one. It's just them in that space, which is amazing, and I'm assuming very hard to do, because you're not feeding off of anybody, just feeding off your own energy, your own thoughts, your own emotions. So I do give credit to every single person that has done these episodes, because I can't imagine how hard it would be. But Anthony Mackie pulled it off very well. He went up and down. We saw the funny parts of Anthony Mackie, and we even got to see a more serious side of him, especially him coming off the Disney Plus series of Falcon and the Winter Soldier. So they go back and forth. It's weird. It's also a beautiful thing to think that we can kind of prepare our families and our loved ones of our departure from this earthly plane into wherever else we go. And it's a very emotional episode. I definitely think Anthony Mackie did his thing in it. And each episode has this cliffhanger, so it kind of bleeds into the next episode, which is going back to what the synopsis is, as we're all connected somehow, some way, and without even meeting each other. The third character is Peg, who is played by the great Helen Mirren, who her story is that She's an older woman, never married, doesn't have any kids, and saw this ad where it was asking for older people, if you want to go on this space adventure, sign up. They don't really touch on base on what the mission is or whatever, but it's just her talking to a computer or a simulation, and he is interjection. So she basically shows that she's always been afraid to try different things. She kind of pushes herself not to do it, and she kind of regrets it. And it leads into other things, which brings us to the third character, which is Sasha, who is played by Uzo Adabu from Orange is the New Black. And But her character has to deal with kind of what we're dealing with now. Yes, everything in these episodes, they're all future. Nothing is present except Anne Hathaway's character. So she is stuck in this beautiful technology house. It's called a stay house. And she's going through the motions, talking to the stay house, him trying to convince her to do something that she's not prepared for. And I mean, this episode was an emotional roller coaster. I mean, she went through conspiracy theories to fear to anger. She did an amazing job with it just being her. And again, they all have cliffhangers at the end of each episode, which leads us into Jenny's character, which is played by Constance Wu. Her episode, it kind of looks like she's sitting in a waiting room. And when I hear waiting room and the way it was done, I think purgatory, like you're floating between life and death. Now, we don't find out until the end, but we do know she goes through these emotions as well. It's definitely an emotional roller coaster with her character as well, from sadness to anger to just not giving a heck and just dealing with a lot of different things. And then we get to what I really liked about it is the fact that it slowly showed us what the episode was going to be about without giving this big tell. And I thought it was excellently executed by Constance Wu. I mean, her emotions, that crying and turning it off, yo, shorty was, she did it. She did amazing in that episode. And again, which pulls us into the next episode, which is Neera, who is played by Nicole Beher. I think I'm saying her last name correctly. If I'm not, I do apologize. Her character, we're in the future now. Basically, she's in a home in I think it's Missouri or Minnesota where she's at, and it's this huge snowstorm, and she's pregnant. And in this episode, it basically just shows us what the future is going to look like with people who would like to have children and necessarily not have do it in the traditional way. And we see all the supplements, vitamins of called Baby Tomorrow, I think it's called. And we're seeing her go through the motions. If she's in labor, we see that her water breaks and that she has these super duper questions about what's going on and not being able to get in contact with her doctor. She does get in contact with the police, who comes way later. And this is this episode that kind of left me kind of sad about us as Black women and having Black children. You guys tell me in the comments if you catch what I caught. Please, I hope somebody catches it. Hit me up in the comments and tell me if you agree or you disagree, or just maybe I'm conspiracy theory and I'm just going over the top. But if you catch it, hit me up in the comments. And then it rounds out to Stewart, who is played by Morgan Freeman. And I love this episode. It kind of rounds out everything that we saw in the past six episodes, and he kind of connects everybody, which shows that theory that we are all connected, even if we're all by ourselves. Everything is connection to something else. And the way he ended it was great. This is the only episode that had more than one person in it. The talks is about memory. You can buy memories, or in Morgan Freeman's character Stewart, he was stealing memories, and this person wanted to know why he did it. And once you guys watch this episode and you hear what Morgan Freeman was saying, it's almost like, is it wrong? It is wrong, but it's like, is this how we're gonna be? And Morgan Freeman's character has dementia, and technology is amazing. I mean, it's amazing right now, but to know what it's going to be like in the future is a whole different thing. Basically, here we are at the end of the review and reaction. At the end of it, I think it was really well done. Anne Hathaway's episode was probably my least favorite. I don't know if she's the first one to kick it off, but I'm saying Anne Hathaway normally does her thing, and her episode synopsis and plot is really what carried her. Everybody else did amazing for being in a room with by yourself and executing each and every character and the things that we have to talk about. So yes, I didn't spoil anything because I would like you guys to go watch it. It is on Amazon Prime and it's called Solos. If you're into anthology, into sci-fi, this is definitely something that you would like. It's definitely a conversation creator because everything in each episode gives you this what if. It's a great conversation starter. I definitely think you guys should go ahead and check it out. And out of 5 stars, I'm going to give Solos a 4, only because, and don't hate me if you guys love Anne Hathaway, because I do too, her episode just wasn't doing it for me. But everybody else's episode was great. And you guys, once you watch it, come back and tell me what you think in the comments. And if you agree with David Wells' thoughts that we're all connected somehow, some way, even if we're just by ourselves and isolated. So that's the end of the video, you guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to click that notification bell so you'll be aware of all the content we upload. And don't forget to subscribe and like the video. And as always, you guys, stay safe and be courageous. And I will see you in the next one.